fatwa yang saya keluarkan bagi pihak Exco yang kita bermesyuarat pada pagi ini. Saya nak baca keputusan Exco pada pagi ini ialah Majlis Mesyuarat Kerajaan Negeri MMK dalam mesyuarat mingguannya pada hari ini telah membuat 3 ketetapan berkaitan dengan pengusahaan Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang kepada Seaport Terminal Johor Sdn Bhd, syarikat yang dikuasai oleh Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Syed Mokhtar Al-Bukhari. Kerajaan Negeri Pulau Pinang, 1. Menolak pensuasaan Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang kepada Seaport Terminal Johor Sdn Bhd kerana ia diadakan tanpa tender terbuka dan tanpa rundingan dengan Kerajaan Negeri. Kerajaan Negeri Pulau Pinang juga telah menulis surat kepada Yang Amat Berhormat Perdana Menteri Datuk Seri Najib Tun Abdul Razak pada 2 Disember 2010 bagi menyatakan hasrat Kerajaan Negeri untuk mengambil alih pensuasaan Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang tetapi tidak mendapat sebarang jawapan. 2. Mendesak Kerajaan Persekutuan menjalankan kerja penggorekan dasar laut bernilai RM353 juta ringgit ke tahap kedalaman 15 meter sekarang dan bukan menyerahkan kerja penting ini kepada Seaport Terminal Johor Sdn Bhd yang mana tidak akan menjalankan kerja penggorekan dasar laut dengan serius dan baik kerana hanya berhasrat menjadikan Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang sebagai feeder port untuk pelabuhannya di Tanjung Kelepas. Yang ketiga, mengecam Pengerusi Suruhanjaya Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Dr. Chua Soi Lek. Dia tak ada berhormat. Tolong gugurkan Yang Berhormat. Mengecam Pengerusi Suruhanjaya Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang Datuk Seri Chua Soi Lek kerana menjual hak rakyat Pulau Pinang dengan membenarkan Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang menjadi feeder port di bawah program perusahaan yang memihak kepada Pelabuhan Tanjung Kelepas yang dijadikan sebagai pelabuhan utama. Okay. Ada apa-apa soalan? Surat yang saya berikan kepada Datuk Seri Najib Tun Razak, saya akan edarkan kepada semua. Okay, any question, Jazah? Yeah.
You're rejecting the proposal to...
We don't agree, we reject. The state government rejects.
What do you hope will come out of this rejection?
No, that the state government has no part in it. Number one, there's no open tender, there was no consultation. And this is not in the interest of the people of Penang. Because they want to make Penang the feeder port. Chua Soi Lek has said it very clearly, Penang is really a feeder port. So he has accepted the fate of Penang. He has condemned Penang to be only a feeder port. And they are not even deepening the channel. You need to deepen the channel to 15 meters for the big ships to come in. So how can we accept this fate as the state government of Penang on behalf of 1.6 million people of Penang Max? We who do not accept Penang Port to become a feeder port. This is against the interests of the people of Penang. Chua Soi Lek, he's from Johor. He can sell off the people of Penang. After all, he can say that he has defended the rights of the people of Johor.
What do you say to
his
statement that he says that the person who privatizes this, after all, has a lot of debt, right? Will not let it go bankrupt, and obviously they will try to make it an international port call.
You must know that this port, he can only form a company to run the port. What is his main port? Tanjung Pelepas or Penang Port? He wants to make Penang Port only the feeder port. His most important port is Tanjung Pelepas Port, which is hundreds of miles away. So let's say if the Penang Port goes bust, it's alright, what? It's only the company, what? Shell company. What? He personally, he will go bankrupt.
Same, you're talking
about who? That's Seri Syed Mokhtar Al-Bukhari. Because it's his company. That is that seaport. And if you want to talk about deepening the channel to 15 meters, if you want to make it a feeder port, would you carry out the dredging works properly or not? We make sure that it is at a depth of 15 meters. We just dredge for the sake of dredging now. So the question is this. The Penang State Government would not accept Penang Port to be reduced in status, to be diminished to the level of being a feeder port. Which is what Chua Soi Lek, which is what Tan Sri Syed Mokhtar, we suspect, is willing to let it become.
Port now, would you say it's an international port of call?
Do you think that it is an international port of call when there's no dredging works?
So what is it now?
We are, I think, in between. We feel that we can restore the port to its former glory of being an international port. You must dredge, and you must also commit yourselves with funding and investments into the port. The federal government was supposed to spend $353 million. They did not do so. Their excuse, since you are going to privatize, let the private company do it. But when they have no intention of making it to a main port, but just a feeder port, do you think they will do the work properly? What for spend that money there? I just spend it at your main port in Tanjung Pelepas. I mean, that would be the normal logic. We hope that will not happen, but what are the assurances? And there's no consultation with the state government. Of course, they can go ahead and do the carry out the operations of the port without any consultation with the state government. But do not forget, some of the pieces of land there are owned and belong to the state government.
So this proposal, this still stands. It's quite unlikely that they'll give it to you, but you're still...
No. I think this proposal is overtaken by events.
Yeah.
But what I want to show to you is that we had written in on 2nd of December 2010. We are not like some people who just talk without any basis and facts. When we talk facts. We don't talk lies. So this proposal was made by me on behalf of the state government in December 2010. But there was no response. So you announced the privatization without any consultation, without any open tender. We think this is not the best deal for Penang. That the interest of the people of Penang has been sacrificed. And that Chua Soi Lek has sold out the rights of the people of Penang. We use the word sold out without any hesitation. Chua Soi Lek, you have sold out the rights of the people of Penang. You cannot fight with the state government, with the federal government, because the federal government owns the operations of the port. But we want to show that we will not be a party, we will not be part of that decision. That's why we reject that decision. Your decision is to make Penang a feeder port. That means it's only a minor port. A feeder port to the main port, which is either in Klang or in Tanjung Pelepas. And this is not the intention of the Penang state government. This may be the intention of Penang Barisan Nasional. But Penang Barisan Nasional is not the Penang state government. The Penang state government stand is very clear. Penang port should not be a feeder port. It should be restored to its former status as an international port. And you cannot just make a decision without consulting the state government, without consulting the people of Penang, and selling out the rights and interests of the people of Penang. Chua Soi Lek has made it very clear. In his interview, he said, Penang is already a feeder port. I think we don't accept that. We reject that. That's why in the third resolution, we say, mengecam Chua Soi Lek kerana menjual hak rakyat Pulau Pinang dengan membenarkan pelabuhan Pulau Pinang menjadi feeder port. Ini adalah keputusan Exco pada pagi ini. Okay?
What if they still refuse to
do this? No, as I said, they have the right. But the state government does not want to have any part of it. And you must bear in mind that there are also certain pieces of land in that area belongs to the Penang state government.
Sir, are you trying to say that you're not going to cooperate with
it? I didn't say that. I said I want to have no part of it. I do not want to go and add anymore. I just said we do not want to have any part of that decision made.
Then can we say that the Sai Mota will face many difficulty in future? Can I say that?
No, I think his main, the main party he has to deal with is the Transport Ministry. Anything he needs to do, the Transport Ministry will have to deal with the state government. Because it's always done through the Suruhanjaya Pelabuhan Pulau Pinang, the Penang Port Commission, or through the Transport Ministry.